Good morning to all of you. Is it audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So a few things I want to discuss before starting the class regarding your quiz one. When are you ready? When shall I get? When can I take quiz one? Yes, Shrikant. What date should we decide for quiz one? Harshit?
Sir, next class would be fine.
Next class on Monday, can we go for? I think Monday is holiday. Okay, Tuesday, right? Tuesday we have class. So on Tuesday, can we go for our quiz? Is it fine for all?
Thursday, sir.
Sorry?
Thursday.
You are not clearly audible. So there would be 10 questions. Okay. One question will carry 1 mark. So we can go for quiz in next. MS Teams would be fine. Or Code Tantra, what you want? I think
MS Teams
would be fine. Yeah.
MS Teams are good.
Okay. We will go for MS Team. I will share question paper and there you will get options only. So you directly click ABC. On the MS Teams, and I will send you separately question paper. So you see questions from the question paper, and there you need to answer directly. Okay. Okay, this is fine. And when quiz two, so I will show you when we can take. Let me share first. For instance, if we are going for quiz one on 30th. Then on 6th, can we go for quiz 2 or some other day? Because then we are April and May. Okay, quiz 2 we will think later. And what about review 2? Because most of you are doing the project which is very much similar to previously what you have done during the IoT fundamental. Am I correct? So we can go for review 2 also because you are well aware about your projects. Yes, any idea? Sen Gupta, when we can go for review 2?
Sir, next week, like after the quizzes.
Next week means we can go 13th?
April? Yes, sir. I guess April we have an exam also from 19th. So
from 19th. So we have to finish before 19th, right? As per curriculum.
So you could start from 6th also, 6th April. Like, it is quite away from the exams.
Yes, correct. It will take time, right? We can start from 6th and up to 13th, we'll try to finish. Is it fine for all? So you can decide accordingly. So 6th April to 13th, we will try to finish review 2. Okay. So nowadays, again, corona cases are increasing. I don't know whether next semester what going to happen. So again, situation is critical. In VIT office also, many corona cases discovered or found. So now HR section is complete. Okay. These are the dates, and now let me show you the syllabus where exactly we are. I think in last class we didn't discuss this one. So in CAT 2 probably module 5th will come and module 6th already covered. So module 4th and 5th will try to cover before 19th. Okay. Whatever highlighted things are available that we covered so far. So reuse and existing IoT solution and reusability plan we will discuss in few slides today. And apart from that, sorry?
Screen is not shared, sir. The silver screen.
Okay, just wait a minute.
And sir, what is the syllabus for quiz?
Yes, that we didn't discuss. So just let me know what should be the syllabus. Now the PDF is visible to you. Is anyone can confirm? I'm sharing syllabus PDF. Is it visible? Nandini?
Sir.
Okay.
No, sir. Actually, only black screen is visible to me.
I can see, sir.
Sir, now it is visible.
It's visible.
Visible, sir.
Okay, Niti, so are you here?
Yes.
Sandru? Okay, fine. So I am sharing again. Okay, so this is the syllabus contents. Shall I keep this development cycle as a one portion in Q1? Development models like water model, agile, spiral, V model, and apart from that, fundamental of IoT. So four or five questions would be from development models and other would be the general questions. Okay. That would be the syllabus.
Can you please repeat the syllabus?
For Q1, there would be five questions from development models, what I have shared on your screen. Here it's highlighted. So these development models are waterfall model, which was the fundamental model, agile and spiral V model. So only this portion we have covered and stages of data life cycle, nothing is there. So rather than that, I will give few questions from IoT fundamentals. Okay, knowledge. So if you know answer, otherwise you just guess it. Is it fine? So more questions I will try to keep from this particular portion, development models. So that would be the syllabus. Apart from that, we will try to do four or three experiments, which is based on this web API or using some Tinkercad or something. So among these 10 experiments, we will try to choose few. And one more thing I have observed, many of you are doing your J component by using these experiments only. So you know among yourself who are doing what. So only few we will do. And if you are literally interested in others, you can attend the others' presentation. So what they are doing, you can learn from them. Okay. So we'll choose almost four or three from this list and we'll try to accomplish. And you try to learn that data exploratory analysis and other things that would be more useful in the interview purpose for MNCs. For many companies nowadays dealing with data analysis. Okay, so we will start from the previous slide, waterfall model. There you can see a few points. If you are not remembering, or now I think everyone can remember what were the steps in the basic fundamental models, because in other models, everything is in form of extended study. Okay, so there were the requirement analysis, design, coding, testing, and the maintenance. A few advantages and disadvantages were there. As a summary or few points, if we look, those points were the pros for the waterfall models are goal were very clear and there were certain direction. Why it's like that? Because same team is going to work at the different phases. That was the advantages. What is advantages in this? Because if same team is going to work on different phase, they have better clarity regarding the project. They can understood the project in better. If separate teams are doing or working on different module means people, some team would be there that having no idea regarding the particular project. So that can be taken as an advantage, and progress can be easily measured. So up to what level you have finished, that can be identified easily. And it saves time and money also, because there is no parallel processing, no multiple iteration. Once completed, you can deliver it. Once time consuming. Customer dissatisfaction, because you are not taking the customer's feedback, you cannot modify accordingly. So ultimately risk factor is high. So two contradictory point is there, save time and time consuming. So how you will understand these points? Save time here in pros is just like you need not to go in the iterative way. In that way, you can save time, but it's time consuming because you cannot start the parallel processing. You cannot do in the separate module. So in that way, it's more time consuming because only a dedicated team is working on the entire project. So they have to complete one phase, then next phase, and so on. So in that way, it's going to consume a bit more time. On the other hand, now we are moving towards the next module. I'm on slide number 91. And it's in full screen mode. If you are not able to see, just let me know. I'll share it again. Hopefully, it's visible to all. Okay, fine. So next SDLC model is and the steps for completing, it's the same. Although we have seen in last class, few points we need to discuss here. So when you are looking towards this model, you have to remember only one word, and what is called the customer satisfaction. Wherever you want the customer satisfaction or you want to take the feedback at the every step, then you have to go for the agile model. And most of the people are following this model, and it's very practical and pragmatic. Okay. So this is just a combination of iterative and incremental model. So two terms frequently we have used. What is called iterative and incremental model. So someone can tell me what is iterative model? Shall I ask manually? Who will say? Shivaji, are you here? Shivaji Chaudhary? Okay, Varnika, what is iterative model? Srikant? Yeah.
So basically, like in that, there is no particular sequence in which we have to go, like unlike waterfall model. So we can go through a certain process again and take feedback from that process. So it's not necessary to complete a process fully to move on to the next part of next stage of the model.
Yes, correct. Someone other want to extend? Harshit Sharma? Harshit, yes, you want sir. To explain?
I agree with her answer.
And what she said is correct. Yeah. Yeah, Harshit, carry on. Harshit, I think your voice is.
So we can say that for. Iterative model with every iteration, like the complexity increases, but again it doesn't check. We can proceed for the next step without checking for the previous one.
Yes, so iterative model is just like this. You are going to do on different iteration. You are doing many iteration. So after one iteration is given to users again. Once you completed the complete task, then it will deliver to the users. Then collect the feedback from the users, and then you will change, you will make the changes according to their requirement. Then again you will start the same processing, that is called next iteration, and so on it will go. Okay, so this particular model is just you can say combination of iterative and incremental. Now I'll ask, what is incremental model? Let me search someone who can say. Tejas, you want to say what is incremental model? How you define incremental model? Because as I said, agile model is just a combination of iterative and incremental model. So Varnika and Ashi said, what is iterative model? In the iterative model, what we are doing, we are just doing on the small project and then again delivering to the users, and we will collect the feedback from the users, and then again we will go for next iteration. So in the many rounds the project is not going to complete. So indirectly what we are getting is customer satisfaction. We are trying to deliver, or we are trying to manage the customer satisfaction, whether customer is satisfied or not satisfied means again we will try to satisfy him. So in that way we are going iteration by iteration. Although what fundamental steps we have seen, we will follow in each iteration. It's like that. Now, can anyone tell me what is incremental model? Sisir Pandya, he was the first person who joined today. Yes, are you here? If you are not here, means you left. India, are you here? Sisir? Okay, Simrit call?
Yes, sir.
Okay, you tell me what is incremental model. I will define incremental model. We have studied many software models, right? How to develop the software and how to design architect. So what was the incremental model? Srikant?
Yes, sir. In incremental model, each step goes through individual checking process and development process. So the final model will be available for customers.
In incremental model also. This is what you are telling for iterative model. You are just making or mixing both. Okay, Srikant, are you here or left? Where is Srikant?
Sir, here, sir.
Yeah, tell me incremental model. How do you define an incremental model? Sivasan?
Sir.
Yeah. How will you explain the incremental model? Let me ask Rahul, are you here? Ritu Sri?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, tell me incremental model. Incremental model. How, what you understood by incremental model in software development life cycle?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, you tell me what is incremental model.
So incremental model is a process of software development where requirements are broken into multiple modules of software development cycle.
Exactly, yeah. That's it.
So it is done in steps from analysis design. It goes to testing also, and that's it, sir.
Okay, so as she said, incremental model, what you are going to do is you are going to divide one bulk or complete problem into small fragments or modules, and different teams are going to work on that module. Practically, you may have observed, you are going for internship or something, they will give you some portion and you are doing or working on that one, but you don't know for whom you are working, whether it's a bank or government sector or whatever. You have no idea on that. You will be given some task and you are just going to complete and going to deliver some project manager or whoever your supervisor. Okay, so incremental model, people are working in same way. How they are just dividing the software, complete software, into the small models, and further it would be integrated. So this point he didn't say. After completing the all, someone would be there like project manager or senior project manager. He will do the analysis and finally he will integrate, and as a whole they will get the complete software, and then further they will test it. Although at the small level people are testing, but here they are not giving directly to the customer. Okay, so only after integration they can do the delivery. While on the other hand, iterative model, they can take the customer feedback also. They can deliver how we have seen in the spiral model. So by having or by inheriting these characteristics, Agile model is quite good model, because it giving the idea regarding the iterative or incremental model. So these features will be there. So in that way, it's good. So one more important thing, in the iterative model, less documentation required. So ultimately, Agile model documentation would be good. That is also advantage, and you can look that one as a disadvantage also, because if your dedicated team fails or something happens, means what would happen to your project, because there is no documentation. How they will start the project? What would be the starting point? So if documentation is there, you can give those documents to anyone. You can give any corner of the world, somewhere, anywhere you can give, and you can accomplish your project. But if documentation is less, again the problem will occur. So that you can take as a disadvantage of this particular Agile model. So the Agile model is look like this. Planning, so for requirement analysis, designing, building, testing, and then you can deliver here after 1 or 2 months. Then after getting feedback, you are going for next iteration. And here you are going to again do the increment. So, and each phase can be done by some separate dedicated team and whom you call as an incremental model, because the complete software is divided into some modules or some sub fragments. So in that way it's going to work. So these are few characteristics of this particular model. More importantly, or you can say very critical point here, is customer satisfaction. Every time here we are going to verify with the customer. That is the important point in this particular model, and we finish the project as soon as possible. Why this point is coming into picture? Here we will try to finish the project with the minimum time, because you are going to deliver at this point itself rather than going end point. Here you will deliver to the customer and you will get the feedback. They are satisfied, stay with this model. You need not to do anything. If they are dissatisfied, again you have to look on the problem and do the study, and you go for iteration. So again and again you have to take some charging fees, some license fee like that, okay, or you are just renewing that one. So step by step you have to take budget, or you can give bill to particular organization, but you are the version of the current software, whatever you delivered in previous phase. So advanced version you are going to deliver, like sometimes you are seeing 0.1, 0.2 or 1.0, then version 2.0, like that. Okay, these are the features of this one. One problem here is we will try to deliver this one in the less time. So people avoid more documentation. They will follow some standard process, so they generally avoid the documentation. That's the problem here. But although clear understanding should be available, so how you can make clear understanding? So dedicated team should be with can do. So if you are newcomers in software industry, you should not adopt this model. You must have the proper documentation, otherwise you will stuck somewhere and then you have to start from the initial point. But very dedicated team and the expertise in particular domain, they are working on this some particular model, means they can go directly without any documentation and directly they can implement. More importantly, here frequent delivery feature is also available. So after 2-3 months you will delivering version by version and taking the customer's feedback. Okay, so this type of modeling also promotes the pair programming, because it's as I said, it's a combination of incremental model. So people can fragment the complete problem into the different module and they can do parallelly, or they can make the pair, and the pair programming also possible. So by doing so, as I said, the delivery at the earliest is also possible, and then they can look for the next stage. One more advantage here is they can choose the particular module of the problem which is really a high risk area or a high risk phase. They can work initially on that one, because as we said, it's incremental like features. It gives incremental like features. So whichever module having the high risk, they can work on that one and then they come back on the remaining module. Okay, so that is also one advantage. What could be disadvantage? Not suiting complex dependencies. That would be problem in this model. So let us look one by one. This is the combination of incremental process, and it focus on the adaptability and the customer satisfaction by rapid delivery of working software product. So working software product, customer will get at the early stage, although they are not getting the fully developed software, but initial stage they are getting, okay, it's good for idea, because when team started recently, although team is very old software, but during pandemic we have started, many features were not there. Nowadays they have included one feature, what is called the noise suppression. So now you can go in setting and you can see here some option, you will get the noise suppression. So dog barking and other fan like noise you will not get. That is the advantage. So I think they also have done in incremental way. Okay, so likewise features you can add, that is the flexibility in this particular model. And then we can break the product into the small incremental builds or small fragments or modules, you can say. So you have heard frequently, I am working on this particular module, I don't know about the other module, how they are working. So in that way, you can understand. And these builds are provided in the iterations. Each iteration typically lasts from about 1 to 3 weeks. So after every 1 to 3 weeks, there is possibility of delivering the product. This particular block diagram we have seen. So development means iteration one, iteration two, and then release, whether customer is accepting or not. Accepting is fine. Otherwise, do the subsequent, or what changes you got, or what changes the customer exactly needs. So you can implement the changes, you can adjust or track, reprioritize the things, and you can go for next iteration. Then you again start the development one, development two, development three, and so on. Why development? Because you are working as an incremental model. So separate modules are there. Again, you integrate it, release it. So in that way, this model is working. So this is the way you can implement everywhere where you want the fast delivery. For example, we want to complete syllabus. We can give one module to one faculty, some other module to other faculty, and so on. And finally, we can get syllabus completion in early stage or before May or April. So likewise we can do. So we are planning to start the gate classes in that manner. Some subject will handle by some other faculty, and finally you will get complete gate syllabus. Okay, so you can implement anywhere, even in hardware industry also this can be implemented, this model. It's not like you have to implement in software. So it's not written here, some agile methodology only written, it's not SDLC, but it's frequently implemented in SDLC. Fine. These are the steps, although we have seen previously also. So some characteristics, whatever we discussed, documentation is not critically important here. Iterative approach is taken. The working software builds is discovered after each iteration. Each build is incremental in terms of features. Final build holds all features required by the customer, because every step we are taking the customer's feedback into the consideration. The agile thought process had started early in the software development, started becoming popular with the time due to its flexibility and adaptability, especially with the customer, because here, customer is the one part of your project. Customer is completely involved, you can say like that. So customer's feedback is given more priority. In that way, you are working on this particular model. Advantages: this model is a realistic approach to the software development. It promotes teamwork and the cross-training. So as a team, you can work, because it's incremental model. Functionality can be developed rapidly and demonstrated. So you can add feature very rapidly, and again, you can deliver fast or within 1 to 3 weeks. Resource requirements are minimum. Suitable for fixed and the changing requirements delivers early partial working solution. So at the early stage, it's possible you can deliver. Good model for environment that change rapidly. Okay, there you can implement this one. So risk management will be less. Here, planning not required that much because you must have some experienced people in that one. Because otherwise, planning and documentation is mandatory. If your team is not having sufficient experience, then you cannot go for this particular model. Otherwise, somewhere you will stuck. And managing is easy because different phases are delivered or tested separately and then integrated. All features what we have studied in water model and other things, all features are inherited here. Gives the flexibility to developers. Many disadvantages are there. Not suitable for handling complex dependencies. That is the biggest disadvantage. Why? Because you are not making proper documentation. More risk, sustainability, manageability, and the extensibility. And overall plan, agile leader and the agile project manager practice is a must, without which it will not work. So experience is required. That's why company people are seeing experience. Once you get experience in one company who are following not some initial model, then other company will take you directly, because now you people have experience and you can go for big project. So that's why the companies are seeing or they are looking towards the experienced people, particularly JP Morgan and other MNCs. Okay, they always opt the experienced person rather than going for fresher. Or many companies will look towards the fresher because they do not want to give big package, or they are working on a small fragment or a small module which were given by some other big company. Okay, strict delivery management dictates the scope, functionality to be delivered, and the adjustments to meet the deadlines. Because if you are getting some module from some big company, then you have to make the timely delivery. Otherwise, the person who is making integration or the manager who is going to integrate all module, he may face problem. Depends heavily on the customer interaction. So if the customer is not clear, team can be driven in a wrong direction. That's the problem. So you may fall into some uninvited problem if customer is not clear about your problem, because he will say something and you will start working without documentation, and ultimately you will waste your time. That could be disadvantage of this particular model. There is very high individual dependency since there is minimum documentation generated. We discussed already this point. Transfer of technology to the new members may be quite challenging due to lack of documentation. Okay, these are the points can be considered as a disadvantage. As a summary, you can see a few points which you must remember. High customer involvement, lesser risk, and the improved quality. Those are pros. And cons, dedicated team is not going to work on complete project. Hard to execute. If you don't have sufficient experience, very difficult to execute this model. Documentation can be ignored. Okay. So now if we are looking back to back on the waterfall model and this particular model, you just see or try to understand block diagram how it's working. So for example, this particular waterfall model followed by some software company, and they just gave you requirement in January, then you spent few months and then you have started in March, and then coding and developers work will start, and then test will would be done, and then it's finally going to be delivered to the customer or users. So end user will get after long span, and here you are spending a lot of time. That's how the waterfall model is working. But on the other hand, if you see this particular model, how we are doing, as among you many said, iterative, what is iterative, what is incremental model. So here you can see small projects. So in January itself, 1 to 3 week, customer will get deliverables here, and whatever feedback they are going to give, again next month you are going to start some new project or incremental project, not incremental, next iteration you are going to start, and then you can make incremental, like you can divide into module, other dedicated team may work on different modules, and then again you can deliver next month, and so on. So process will go like that. So in from this block diagram you can get clear crystal idea from basic model to the more versatile model, what is called agile model. These are the steps which we are following in IoT design methodology. So somewhere we have studied, or we have to follow these steps what we have studied in previous slides. So this one I will explain next class. So going to depend on some other slide. Other important point is reuse existing IoT solutions and reusability plan, because it's very easy to purchase new things, but many problems may occur. So it's a very good idea. Whole world is looking towards the IoT. Everyone wants IoT based equipment. Everyone wants to take the benefits or want to make life better by using the IoT based or IoT enabled environment. But it's not good idea just use and then throw it. So it's very good idea, use the existing technology, or just try to reuse, and what is planned for reusability. So somewhere you have seen this particular symbol, recycle, reuse and reduce, for the paper and for the tin cans, for other things you have seen. But now in the modern day or modern day communication system, people are looking for reusability, and what are the chances of the reuse the existing components, or some equipment is there, what can be reused for new equipment. So that idea should be extended if we are moving towards the IoT based world. Okay, so what could be these ideas? Reusing existing component, establish development, new technology in less time. That could be the advantage. We can use resources in better way. Right, for instance, VAD is establishing now the new smart boards. So few existing boards are there. What to do with those boards? Although that is not IoT thing, but what to do? It's not good idea simply throwing it somewhere. So they can put those boards somewhere in research scholars room or somewhere. So there the upcoming faculty or scholars can use for their training purpose. That could be the idea, or they can reuse these resources rather than directly dumping somewhere. So one of the main functionalities that can be reused is related to the device management layer and the black box reuse. Okay, so old computers, hard disk, you can use somewhere. So storing the you can say data collected by CCTV, so there you can use old computers which doesn't have good clarity, that can be used for some such purposes. They can given to security officer somewhere. You can implement, so rather than throwing, you can use in same way the IoT based sensors or many components you can use at different stages, or you can try to reuse all those things. So steps involved in the reusability plans are: identify the reusable assets, integrate reusable assets. How to integrate the reusable assets in order to make the new system? You can use those assets to make some new project. Black box reuse and white box reuse, two frequently used terms, are the assets that are integrated into the new system simply as they are. So that is called black box reuse. White box reuse, new functionalities that implemented on the existing component for the by integrating them. So in that way you can use. For instance, nowadays mobile, what problem I observed is which mobile we have used, whatever mobile we have used for 3G, we cannot update to 4G. That is really big problem. Otherwise we can save some money, we can simply upgrade it. For example, laptop, what you are using and someday you need it's a high RAM, then they already providing some flexibility, you can increase its RAM. So likewise, functionality should be included, or that should be the feature of your IoT based equipment. In the IoT development, due to large scale operation when building application, it is important to know from the beginning the reuse strategy for the integrating component based on type of functionalities that can be reused. So that point should be kept in mind, whether that can be reused or not. So nowadays many offers are going on, like exchange, you can exchange the things on Flipkart or somewhere. So what they will do, they will for these steps, okay, they will follow these steps and then they will take out some new things and then they will insert into the even in the new gadget. That's why sometimes we are facing problem also, after purchasing few days system will fail. That could be the reason I'm saying from on behalf of myself. Okay, so nowadays these things are also going on. A few points extending this study: evaluate the reusable assets. So necessary to assure that the quality of reusable component does not compromise overall. That should be our idea. Otherwise you are paying same amount and in the end you are not getting that kind of performance. Quality of application, and they do not deteriorate the quality of the new system. So quality of new system should not be deteriorated. Extendable, handle to variability and the homogeneous devices and technologies. So these are the features which you have to keep in your mind while you are planning for reusing the IoT based equipment, or how to reuse. It would be really good idea if we can reuse or we can upgrade the system. You find these are same points: reduce, reuse and recycle. So that triple R should be kept in mind so that we can take the advantage. A few components which can be reused, these are cloud data storage, cloud services, different type of sensors that can be reused. You can use controller also. You can make some other projects. IoT platform and the computing devices that are frequently used here that can be reused. So I'll stop here. We'll start some new topic in the next class. Okay, so I'll take attendance from the inside, however I'm downloading also for safer purpose. Okay, thank you, I'm signing off. See you in next class.
This is on Tuesday, right?
Yes.
Okay.
We will try to manage around 8:30, so in 10 minutes.
Can it be on Thursday? I have another queue, sir.
Other quiz, so far we not decided on what date we are going to take. So first we will deal with Q1 and afterwards we will see.
Okay.
So now only think about quiz one only.
No, sir. I said can it be on Thursday, next week Thursday, I said, because I have another quiz.
Okay, you do not want on Tuesday. It's not on Thursday, I am keeping on Tuesday. Date is 6th. Okay, wait a minute, what I have written here. So what day you want? You want on 30th or 6th? I think 30th we will keep quiz one, okay? That is finalized. Is it fine? So you have on Thursday some other assignment, so we will keep on 30th for 10 minutes.
So could it be at 9 o'clock, sir, rather than 8:30?
9 o'clock. So 9 o'clock, others may have some other class, then how we will complete?
8:30 is fine.
Otherwise, we can start at 8:20 also. Okay, 8:20 or 8:20. This will say so we have class and this.
Thing. Sir, do you mean 9:20, sir? Because 8:20 will be in other class now, sir.
So, sir, what time other class?
Sir, our class is from 9 to 10, no, sir.
No, 8 to 9 only.
So on Tuesday we have class from 8 o'clock.
Okay. Okay, sir. Yeah.
So in the class timing, oh, it's okay, sir.
Yeah. So okay, fine. I'm just signing off now. Thank you.